joined by our MVP, Jeremiah Ismeus and Paul Rogers. Jeremiah, 10 points, 9 rebounds, 3 blocks, but every single important play down the stretch. You score the game-winning basket, you come up with the steal on the next possession, and then the contest on Bosquet where you don't draw the foul, don't give him the three-point play. You came in because Javi Ellis fouled out. What were you trying to do with your team down by a single point in the state playoffs?
I was trying to fill in the gaps for my teammates. They believed in me, my coaches believed in me, and I had heart, and I played to my fullest potential.
What does it feel like to score the game-winning basket in a state playoff game as a sophomore with a huge crowd in front of you?
It feels good. Like, to be honest, it just feels good to win that game, move on to states, and to be with my teammates. That's it.
You guys, you play behind Javi Ellis, who's obviously a phenomenal player, but you were huge in this game, rebounding extremely well. What's kind of the focus as a younger player on the varsity team? What has coach kind of told you? What have some of the older guys told you about your role and what you need to do for this team?
My teammates always told me to focus. Coach does the same thing. He says I should put in all my hard work into what I'm doing so that I can probably get a scholarship in the future. That's it.
Well, the focus paid off today. Congratulations, Jeremiah. We'll bring in Coach. Coach, this was a wild one. You guys went up by 6. It looked like maybe you would pull away. Then they came back, that crazy possession, multiple fouls. They end up going up by a point. Mm-hmm. How did you try to settle your team down? What was kind of the key message to your team when you went down by a point?
I told them that I believe we're going to win this game. I said, we've been doing this all year. We played tough games, tough opponents all season long. We haven't lost a D4 game yet, and we don't expect to lose one. So that's it.
Jeremiah Ismeus, great story. A sophomore who every single big play down the stretch, today was his day.
Yep.
What does that say about your team? Because it was Ismeus, Kapilen did a great job in the second half handling the ball. It wasn't your starters who necessarily had to carry the load. Mm-hmm. What does that say about your team's depth?
I've been saying it all year. You can ask any of my friends. I love my guys. They play so hard, and they play for each other. So, like, that's an expectation for us. Next man up. That's it.
This is your first trip to the sectional finals in 8 years.
Yep.
What does that mean for this program?
You know what? Bookend. Like, that was my first year as a coach at Snowden. We got there, makeshift lineup. We had like 6 guys that could kind of play in an eighth grader. And we were flying by the seat of our pants. Now our program is more established, but like we're gonna enjoy this tonight. We're gonna get ready for awesome prep on Friday.
We saw Fenway win.
Yep.
They'll be playing ahead of you guys on Friday. Yep. What does it mean to have 2 city schools go there? A little bit of city camaraderie on the road.
You know what? Boo is like a mentor to me. He's a phenomenal coach. I mean, 20 city championships, 3 state championships. So, like, we're excited. We're excited to be there with them. Like, we're going to go through this experience as Boston residents together.
Congratulations on the victory. It was a very exciting one. Guys, take it away.